In this lesson, we're going to again look at the states of matter, and we're going to look at the properties of each, specifically to lead us into a discussion about the behavior of gases only. So previously we looked at the changes in state or changes in phase going between solid, liquid, and gas. And so we talked about the different terminology we use to describe that. Now we want to look at the differences between gases, liquids, and solids. And this is important because we need to understand why gases behave the way they do, because when we start to look at their properties, we can understand why that is the case. So when I look at a gas, what I see is that the molecules or particles, they may be atoms, they may be molecules, are far apart from one another. In a liquid, they are close together. And in a solid, they are even closer together. And so these latter two, the liquid and solid, we actually call condensed phases because those particles are so close to one another. So in a gas, if we were to draw this to scale based on the size of these molecules that we've represented here, we would actually only see one of these particles in this container. Because compared to the size of the molecules, gas molecules are very, very far apart from one another. And this has important consequences because what this means is that there is little to no interaction between those molecules, and that they are moving freely. So unlike looking at liquids and solids where the molecules are interacting with one another, where we see intermolecular forces happening, in gases we don't see that happening. And so in liquids and solids we have to worry about intermolecular forces, okay, because they're close enough together they're interacting with one another, and that's not the case with gases. And what this allows us to do is to now start predicting the behavior of a gas when we start changing things like the pressure or the volume or the temperature. So looking a little more closely at gases, what we see is that their motion is completely random. So these molecules are moving in all different directions. They bounce off one another and go off in a different direction, but their movement is not dependent on other particles, unlike liquids and solids, which we have to deal with intermolecular forces. The predictable behavior lets us predict how something is going to change depending on the change in one or more variables. And that molecules occupy only 1% of the space compared to 70% for liquids. So when we look at a sample of a gas, the vast majority of it is in fact empty space. Because again, those particles are very far apart from one another relative to their size.